Hi friends, in this video we will understand about Rolle's theorem and its physical interpretation. According to Rolle's theorem, if a real valued function y is equal to fx is defined on a closed interval ab such that this function is continuous in closed interval ab, it is differentiable on open interval ab, and also the value of function at two extremes of the interval, that is the value of function at x is equal to a is equal to the value of function at x is equal to b, then there will always exist at least one point c between a and b, that is in open interval ab, such that the differentiation of function at that point will be zero. That is, if function is continuous in closed interval ab, it is differentiable in open interval ab, and value of function at x is equal to a is equal to the value of function at x is equal to b, then there will always be a point x is equal to c in between a and b, at which the differentiation of function, that is f dash c, is zero. Now we come to the physical interpretation of Rolle's theorem. As differentiation of a function, that is dy by dx, always gives the general expression for slope of tangent to the curve. Hence, f dash c must give the slope of tangent to y versus x curve at point c. Thus, f dash c equal to 0 implies that slope of tangent to y versus x curve at point c is 0. That is, at point x is equal to c, the tangent is parallel to x axis. And it can be seen graphically. Say a graph of the function starts from x is equal to a, and at x is equal to a the value of function is fa. The value of function changes as the value of x changes from a to b. Say from x is equal to a, graph follows this path to reach at x is equal to b, and say it is the curve 1, and it is not the only curve. The curve may be this way or may be this way. So whatever may be the shape of the curve, there will always be at least one point for the curve at which tangent will be parallel to x-axis, that is slope of tangent will be 0, and for curve 1, this one will be the point at which tangent will be parallel to x-axis, while for curve 2, there will be 5 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points on which tangent will be parallel to x-axis. And if we come to the curve 3, then there will be again 5 points on which the tangent will be parallel to x-axis. And according to Rolle's theorem, there must be at least one point between a and b for which tangent to the curve will be parallel to x-axis. That is, slope of tangent to the curve at that point will be 0. So x is equal to c will be corresponding to these points at which slope is 0. It was all about Rolle's theorem. Questions related to Rolle's theorem will be of two types. First, in which we will have to check the applicability of Rolle's theorem to a given function on a given interval. The second type, in which we will have to verify Rolle's theorem for a given function on a given interval. To solve questions related to Rolle's theorem, we will be using following results: polynomial function, sine function, cosine function, exponential function, all will be continuous as well as differentiable everywhere, means for all real values. Logarithmic function will be continuous and differentiable only in its domain, while modulus function will not be differentiable at x is equal to 0, though it will be continuous for all real values of x. Though tangent function is differentiable, but it will not be continuous at x is equal to 2n minus 1 pi by 2. It means tangent function will not be continuous for odd integral multiples of pi by 2. Also, some difference, product, quotient of two differentiable or continuous functions will also be continuous or differentiable. Now we will apply Rolle's theorem to solve questions. And we know that the questions related to Rolle's theorem will be of two types. One, in which we will have to verify Rolle's theorem, and second, in which we will have to test the applicability of Rolle's theorem on a function in a given interval. The function which is given in the question, on which we have to discuss the applicability of Rolle's theorem, is defined as fx is equal to minus 4x plus 5 if 0 less than equal to x less than equal to 1. Here we see that the function from 0 to 1, that is within the closed interval 0 to 1, is a polynomial function. And we know that a polynomial function is always continuous as well as differentiable for all real values. Also, for 1 less than x less than equal to 2, that is for the interval open at 1 and closed at 2, the function is defined as 2x minus 3, and again it is a polynomial function, hence will be differentiable as well as continuous within this interval. To discuss applicability of Rolle's theorem to this function, we will discuss the continuity of function in closed interval 0 to 2, differentiability of function in open interval 0 to 2. Also, we will find whether the value of function at lower limit of the interval, that is 0, is equal to the value of function at upper limit, that is value of function at x is equal to 2. If all these three conditions will be satisfied, then we will say that Rolle's theorem is applicable to this function. If any one of the three conditions will not be satisfied, then Rolle's theorem will not be applicable to the function. Say, first we want to check whether the value of function at x is equal to 0 is equal to the value of function at x is equal to 2 or not. Then say value of function at x is equal to 0, that is f0 will be, for x is equal to 0, function is minus 4x plus 5, so it will be minus 4 into 0 plus 5, that is 5. And the value of function for other extreme, that is value of function at x is equal to 2, will be For x is equal to 2, function is 2x minus 3. So 2 into 2 minus 3, that is 1. As f0 is not equal to f2, the Rolle's theorem will not be applicable to the given function. It was the one way. Also, if we want to check the continuity of the function, then within this interval, the function is polynomial, so it will be continuous. Within this interval also, the function is polynomial function, so it will be continuous. Hence, in order to check the continuity of function, we will have to concentrate on point where x is 1, because for x equal to or less than 1, the function is this, but for the value of x slightly more than 1, the function will be 2x minus 3. It means the function is changing itself at x is equal to 1. So we will test the continuity at x is equal to 1. For checking the continuity, we will have to find out left hand limit of the function and right hand limit of the function. Left hand limit of the function at x is equal to 1 will be limit x tends to 1 negative fx this is equal to limit x tends to 0 f 1 minus h this is equal to limit x tends to 0 and for a value slightly less than 1 the function is minus 4x plus 5 that is minus 4 into x is 1 minus h plus 5 and if we will put h is equal to 0 then it will become minus 4 plus 5 that is 1. Now RHL of function limit x tends to 1 positive fx this is equal to limit x tends to 0 f 1 plus h and this is equal to limit x tends to 0 for a value slightly more than 1 function is 2x minus 3 so it will be 2 into 1 plus h minus 3 and putting h is equal to 0 we get 2 minus 3 and 2 minus 3 is minus 1 as LHL is not equal to RHL so the function is not continuous. LHL not equal to RHL implies function is not continuous in closed interval 0 to 2. Also, if we want to test its differentiability, because all the three conditions should be satisfied for application of Rolle's theorem to the function. So if we want to test the differentiability of function at x is equal to 1, then we will find out left hand derivative of function at x is equal to 1 and left hand derivative will be limit x tends to 1 negative fx minus f1 upon x minus 1. and this implies limit h tends to 0, f x will be replaced by 1 minus h, f1 minus h minus f1 upon 1 minus h minus 1. This is equal to limit h tends to 0, f1 minus h for a value less than 1, fx will be minus 4x plus 5, so minus 4, and x means 1 minus h minus, sorry, plus 5 divided by minus h. This is equal to, if we will put h is equal to 0, then it will become infinite, because minus 4 plus 5 upon minus 0, undefined. Now right hand derivative, infinite. It shows the derivative of function at x is equal to 1 is not defined. That is, function is not differentiable at x is equal to 1. Since the function is not differentiable at x is equal to 1, we will say that the Rolle's theorem is not applicable to the function. If you think that this video is of any help for you, then please share it with your friends so that they may also be benefited by it.